Yo, what up, though? It's your boy, Paige Kennedy, and y'all got to go check me out right now on the Bootleg Cab Podcast, baby. You already know what time it is, 313.
Hey, what up, man? Before we start the interview, want to shout out to Imperial Extraction. Look, man, they got these 2-gram THCA diamond-loaded pre-rolls and so much more. They got the carts. They got everything going down, and you can get 20% off right now if you go to ImperialExtraction.com. That's ImperialExtraction.com, but you got to use the promo code BOOTLEG20. This that Yoda OG. Premium, 20% off, sent right to your door. THCA diamond-loaded pre-rolls and so much more. ImperialExtraction.com, promo code BOOTLEG20. Let's get to the interview. Yo, Bootleg Cab Podcast, special guest here, Paige Kennedy. Welcome.
What up, though? Hey, you see what I did there? What up, though?
What up, though?
Pizza? Hey, Detroit-style pizza in his...
So you're from Detroit?
I don't eat this?
No, not till you rap.
Oh, okay.
You're from Detroit originally?
Yeah. I'm from the D, 313. Yep.
East side, west side?
West side of Detroit.
They're more player on the west side.
Born and raised. I mean, they definitely are more something on the west side.
I was like, when you go to Detroit, I've been to Detroit, hung out on both sides often. But they always say, like, the west side is kind of like Harlem in New York. Like, more fly, more like about their fashion. The east side is more like...
More like you want to
like the Bronx.
Go there to die.
Right.
That's how I categorize it.
Yeah. But I f*** with Detroit, man. That was actually one of the coolest places that we got to travel to and record content.
What was you doing in Detroit?
Just shot a bunch of interviews. We went out there. We were hanging out with, like, Icewear Vezo and Peasy and...
Where did they have you at?
Payroll Giovanni. Everywhere. I mean, dude, we were in Soda Baby's, like, trap house on the east side. Like, it was crazy. Eesh. Motherfuckers was outside with bazookas.
Yep, I wouldn't have been there.
But it was cool. Like, the food was... I mean, the Coney Islands were whatever. Let's be honest.
That's all we eat.
I know, but
Coney,
it's like...
So it's like...
I get why it's like... People are like, you gotta go and get a good... Like, hit a good Coney when you're in Detroit. And we went to, like, 4 of them. And it was all just like, yeah. I mean, this is...
What'd you get there? You get the chili fries with cheese?
I think we got a lot.
Oh, you, like, just got a bunch of shit, huh?
Yeah, sandwiches. I mean, I think one place we got cheesecake, chicken wings, hot dogs, chili cheese fries.
Come on, man. I'm trying to diet, and you over here bringing up all of this. Look, I'm an addict, bro. I'm 4 days in, and I got water. I got water.
I got water and diet soda, which is terrible for you.
What is that? Diet Pepsi? Diet Coke?
Diet Coke.
Oh, okay.
Which isn't good for you.
Is not. Is almost as bad as just drinking the sugar. That's what I heard.
Well, there's some called. Is it called aspartame? Yeah, it's like causes cancer, right? So
you was like, life. Let me just drink this.
You know, hey, no calories though, right?
Hey, shout out to that.
It's worth it.
Hell yeah.
but yeah, no, I with Detroit. Detroit's a vibe. It's a good place, man. Hip hop history there.
Yeah, and you know, in my opinion, we got the best MCs, but it's interesting because
some of them, yeah, M, Royce,
yeah, see, it's bifurcated,
LZI.
Right? See, you saying my top rappers, but it's different because you got the lyricists like M,
right,
Sean,
Guilty Simpson,
Royce,
yeah,
L, you know what I mean,
Black Milk,
Paige Kennedy, and then you got the other side of it, which is the people that you was
I with the new shit, though, because honestly, like the new Detroit. And it ain't even like the new, because like Icewear Vezo has been around for a minute, and like Doughboy Cash Out and those guys, like Payroll Giovanni's been around forever. But it's definitely like the new wave of Detroit and Flint has influenced so much of hip hop now. It's kind of crazy. Like people in Flint, like Rio the Young OG and RMC Mike, like
John Connor. Shout out to John Connor.
John Connor's amazing.
That nigga's.
But those two guys specifically, though, have like. Really influenced a lot of the new guys in a way that is kind of crazy. Like a lot of guys rap that if you close your eyes, you would think it was like Rio the Young OG was writing for them. Mm. Shout out to Flint though, man. But John Connor's fire for sure.
Yeah.
John, but like you Connor, said, that's like different. Man. That's like more. Detroit's,
yeah,
like
the lyrical shit.
Super lyrical, backpack, crazy bars, or
I die.
But
or the East Side.
But the new shit is different. It's like, you know, there's like a kid named Babytron who's. Fucking what is he 19, 20, and he's just got dope like punch lines, and Cash Kid is fire.
Oh, yeah, Cash Kid, Cash Kid.
Cash Kid is hard. It's just different.
It's so funny. How come? Look, my favorite out of, so I love PZ, but like my favorite out of all those type of Detroit rappers is T Grizzly. Like, he's my favorite.
Yeah, I mean, T Grizzly's the guy who everybody says kicked the door down nationally for that sound.
He did, because
now, he wasn't
before,
the first guy.
He wasn't, but he was the guy who made everybody know what that sound is.
Correct. Yes, nationally for sure.
Yeah. And then he kept going. You know, like I love every T Grizzly album that he put out. Like, every time.
Yeah, T Grizzly's hard, and like he put out a whole visual album. Like,
oh yeah, with the stories. Yeah, he was like on his King Von
acting in every video.
Yep.
That's gonna fall, Cyrus. Don't want that to hit you in the fucking head, buddy. But shout out to Detroit, man. So when did you start acting?
Shit, I started.
Like, did you move to LA and like chase it, or were you like doing some like back home, or like, you know? Because
no, well, you know, I knew I was gonna be an actor since like I was little. Like, Michael Jackson has been my everything my whole life. You know,
right.
Straight up, like of why I wanted to be an entertainer started from him when I was little.
Right.
So I actually started rapping first. Like, I was a rapper through elementary school, middle school, high school, best in schools, and so I started acting in community college because I went to play football and I didn't make the team. So I was like, you know what? I know I want to be an actor. I know I want to move to LA. Let me just start in theater.
Right.
So I started in theater in Grand Rapids Community College. Then I went to theater at Western Michigan University. Then I went to Shakespeare. I went for classical theater, you know, for my master's in at the University of Delaware. So when I got to California, I was ready. I was
already kind of like a seasoned.
Yeah. And you know, and I thought I was coming here to do both, like, you know, but the acting is what kicked off before the music did. Mm. Even though I had been doing the music way longer than that, that's what was feeding me. You know what I'm saying? Because my story of how I even got started is crazy here. Like, I call it my Jay Leno story.
So what happened? Like, you moved to LA. What was the first acting break you got?
I moved here February 2001.
Okay.
And I was here for 1 month. And I heard about this audition called The Kennedys, ironically enough. And I snuck into the audition at Sony Studios. Like, I didn't even have my own car. I was sleeping on somebody's couch.
Right.
I didn't have a job. I didn't have an agent. I had Like, I heard about it. So my boy drove me there. And we were like, oh, we making a delivery. But I was really delivering myself, right. You know. And I gave them my headshot and resume, and they saw I didn't have an agent, but they just saw like 20 theater credits, and they was like, 20
credits, yeah.
Yeah, so they let me audition, and that was my big break, because they tap hardy me. I got the part in a CBS pilot starring with Randy Quaid. And
Randy Quaid, man.
Randy Quaid, I know. That's
Vegas Vacation, man.
Man, what happened to Randy Quaid, bro? I see his brother, but dang.
I feel like Randy Quaid is... I'm 99.999% sure he's like a wild, like, right-wing conspiracy theorist now on Twitter.
Oh, Randy Quaid's on Twitter?
He's a wild boy, for sure.
I mean, he was a wild boy then. I went to his wife's birthday party. I remember he took me to his house. Oh, my God, bro. This was the biggest door I ever seen. It looked like a giant lived in that house. Like, it didn't even
he
look
looks like a tall guy. Is
yeah,
he tall?
I mean, he
looks
hell,
tall on TV.
He's not fucking 12 feet tall, but this his door looked like Jolly Green Giant lived there. And then they took me to a strip club. This is for his wife's birthday. Yeah, that shit was yeah, here.
Nice. Yeah, LA strip club.
So that's how I got started.
So what was the name of that show? The Kennedys?
It was called The Kennedys. It was a pilot that never got picked up.
Never got picked up.
Yep.
How much of that happens? Where there's just pilots getting produced for nothing?
All the time.
Yeah.
I mean, not no more, because, you know, our whole system is fucked up now.
Well, it used to be like you get a sitcom and you make it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, now it's like you get a podcast that pops off and you're like...
Right, exactly, because that's where the main shit is.
Especially comedians.
Yeah, because look, right now, it's so oversaturated that you can be on a show and don't nobody know who the fuck
exactly.
You are. Like, look at the people on CBS with the quiet money. They've been on, I don't know, FBI Transylvania or some shit, and they rich as hell. But if you walked to them in Ralph's, you would have never even recognized.
Yeah, there's so many, like, it's between all the streaming services and then still CBS and NBC. It's like, I can't keep up with
it. Yeah, it's too much.
Shit. Like, I watch what I watch, and If you ain't on them shows,
right, then you don't know. I mean, you gotta really, your show has to really pop. Like, you gotta be on Netflix or...
Yeah, like, there's a few guys, like, if I, like, I've watched, like, you know, I'm not a big fan of, like, the SVU type shows, but, like, I've watched, like, Chicago PD enough times if I saw a guy. But, oh, that's the guy from that show.
Like,
that's...
the older black dude.
You just throw it on in the background?
Right.
Because you don't need to, like, know. Like, Shamar Moore, right? I was just in a wedding with Shamar. He's one of my best friend's best friends. And I was just picking his brain about it, and I was like...
About SWAT?
About SWAT. Because they brought it back after it was canceled.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. But he was just saying, he was like, yo, like, I think they're going into season 8?
Of SWAT?
Yeah. 7 or 8.
Damn. I did not know
but
that
he
was
saying,
on
he was like, you know, this is about the time, like, shows stop. So he's like, I don't know, you know, we've had a great run. I don't know if the run's going to keep going or not, but... He's like, now's about the time where you kind of got to look and be like, how long is this going to go?
Right, and what I'm going to do now. I mean, but
I mean, he had Criminal Minds. Money. He had, yeah. I mean, Shamar Moore's fucking...
Yeah, he's so stupid rich.
He's doing fine.
See, that's that quiet money. Think about the people that are on that show that you don't know, but they...
Yeah, I only know him. Well, and I met one dude, the Asian guy off that show, but I don't know his name. I've met him at my friend's house a bunch. But yeah, but like you said, there's so many shows, like there's shows on CBS and... Peacock. I'm like, I don't know these people. Like, if it's not Larry David,
you fuck with Kirby.
It's my favorite show.
Yeah,
it's my favorite comedy.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, it's the best.
Oh, so you like Seinfeld too, then?
Of course. Yes, right. I was a Seinfeld guy first.
Right.
Again, same. Had all them DVD box sets, man.
Me too. The first one. That was the first show I got all the DVD box.
I feel like it might have been the first DVD box setted show, low key.
That was the.
It was like the colorful sleeves. Each season had its own color.
I got that, and then I got Family Guy box set.
You're right. Family Guy box
set. I got
set.
Seinfeld and then
honestly,
Family Guy
on DVD is what really reinvigorated that show. Because if you think about it, Family Guy was like kind of like it was kind of like a cult classic until it got put on DVD, and then everybody fucked with it, and then it's like the biggest shit ever.
And it got canceled 3 times.
That's what I'm saying. The DVD demand is what brought people back to it, and then they had to bring it back. Because, yeah, that's crazy. Shout out to Family Guy, man. That was a f***ing era. And The Sopranos on DVD.
Hey, are you enjoying the new Curb? I mean,
yes.
The final Curb?
I am. I already know what's going to happen. It's going to be like Friends. Or it's going to be like Seinfeld. He's going to end up in jail.
Larry's going to end up in jail?
I think he is. All because he fucked his lawyer up with his boyfriend's husband.
You think Larry's going to end up in jail? As old as he is,
yes.
He's going to end up in jail.
Because his lawyer fucked up his plea deal. And why did his lawyer fuck up his plea deal? Because he was up all night arguing with his husband because Larry gave him about the name of the kid. Mm. And at the end, I feel like the end is going to be just like, I feel like he's going to purposely do what he did with Seinfeld. Everyone's going to get tied together at the end that don't f*** with him, and he's going to end up in jail. He's going to end up having to go sit down.
I mean, isn't he going through this sh- now anyway? Like, because he gave that lady some water in line?
That's what I'm saying. He's going to have to go to jail for that.
That's crazy.
Because he was going to plead, and then, yeah, it's and then he f***. Yeah, I didn't see the one that just ran Sunday.
Yeah, I didn't see that yet.
The last one I saw was... where he had the spray paint in the back of his car, and the cop was like, and they were painting dicks on on all the billboards.
For all of you who don't know what we're talking
it's
about.
It's a great show.
We're talking about white people shit.
I'm very sad that it's over. But
yeah,
he's old. And, you know.
I know.
You know, what's his face?
He couldn't
away.
Even get out of the golf cart. I told my son, because my 11-year-old likes Curb Your Enthusiasm a lot, which why would a 11-year-old? I don't know. But in his acting class, they were talking about
Richard Lewis.
Yeah, and he was like, I know him. I watch him on and I'm sorry, but I did like prognosticate this to him. I said, listen, bro, you see the fact that he in this golf cart and he don't get out of it, right? They just bringing him along because he probably can't stand or walk, but they want him in the season.
Well, even the whole season where they're arguing about who's in each other's will.
Yeah.
It's like,
I mean, he been presentiment that he was
like,
out of
why won't you, when will you die?
Exactly. And he started that the first season. Look, we went back and started the first season when it looked crazy.
For sure.
I don't know how many, 20 years ago or something?
Something like that.
He was talking about dying in.
Yeah. Not for sure. Rest in peace, Richard Lewis, man.
Rest in peace, Richard Lewis.
So you are a part of a, would you say Weeds was your first big, big break?
Maybe. SWAT, Weeds, probably. Listen, it must be because to this day, my main fan base comes from Weeds and Blue Mountain State. So, like, if you know Paige Kennedy, it's usually because of one of those two. That's where the cult following comes from.
Right. And for people who don't know, Weeds is, like, probably the first, like, super successful Showtime show, I would say. I don't know what else there was before Weeds that was, like, popping.
No, because Weeds was before Dexter. Was the and same
Weeds,
time.
I think Weeds was before Californication a little bit.
I think it was running at the same time.
Californication was fire. Shout out David Duchovny.
Yeah. That shit was dope.
And Homeland was fire too. Until it wasn't.
8 seasons though. Jesus.
That's what I'm saying. Once the Brody guy died, I'm like,
yeah, they were struggling after that.
But
same with me. And Weeds.
Well, because for people who don't know, you were like this lady's husband dies in the show. She's a suburban house mom. And then she turns into a weed dealer to kind of just help pay the bills, essentially. And then she ends up kind of being like a weed, just a giant weed dealer. Like a, what am I trying to say? Like a big dope dealer, you know? But you were like her plug, her first plug.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Because Romney, like, the other black guy on there, they went into it together.
And they were right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, I haven't watched the show in so long. And then you knew that guy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And then they brought me in.
Was it your mom?
His mom. Or his auntie.
His auntie. Okay. Yeah. So it was definitely like old. That was like kind of like, to me, the era of like TV changing a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Because before that, I feel like there wasn't a lot of, like, outside of The Sopranos, and if you were, like, an HBO head and you watched Oz and The Wire and which I feel like The Wire got more popular after it got finished.
Yeah, for sure.
But I feel like that Weeds era TV was, like, kind of the real first, like, binge popular, like, time where people were like, yo, and that was when the DVDs were popping. I remember my dad would buy all the, like, he'd be like, son, when's the new season of Weeds coming, and how long do I have to wait for it to come on DVD? I'm like, just get fucking Showtime. I don't want to get Showtime. But what was it like being a part of that show?
Listen, as an actor, that probably was the show that I grew the most, you know, because, like, the first season, I came on season 2, so I was there from season 2 and season 3, and when I came on there, you know, I was like, I was good. I was doing my thing. But it wasn't until season 3 where, like, after the Mexican standoff happened at the finale, that's one of the coldest finales
for sure
that I can think of after season 2, that season finale. But where nobody knows what's about to happen.
Right.
You know, and we got to wait through the whole summer to
find out
Well, the hoopla for the U-turn character was so big that they made the decision to let the story go towards me, right? And so at this point, I didn't really get to talk to Mary Louise Parker. Like, you don't even, like, look at her. Like you do your scenes, but that's it. Like, I didn't have a relationship with her. But then when season 3 came, and it's just me and her, and she really got to see, like, I'm not just, like, I'm, like, for real. Like, we are two titans going at each other. Her respect for me changed, and we became, like, really close friends. You know what I'm saying? And so doing scenes with her specifically, and also Romney, because we had that, the little gun on the table thing. Like, here, this is what happened. When we first came back, the first episode in season 3, I got sick. So I was sick, so my energy was really low because I didn't feel good. And then my voice was kind of weird because, you know, that happens when you get sick. So when I'm doing my scenes, I learned a new color to my acting that I didn't have before. I used to call it the white TV voice is what I called it. It's like when they talk in a whisper.
Like Batman.
Yeah, like, but like that's how they do on TV, yeah. Like when they're bad guys. I never knew how to do that. I'd be on my couch. I'm like, I sound stupid when I try that. But because
you were
my body forced me to slow down, that's why I was able to talk to her in a way where I was going to rip her throat out and bury it where all my weed was buried. Like, I was able to do that and had a confidence. Because right. Normally I wouldn't have the confidence. I'm trying to fucking say my lines again so I wouldn't get in trouble or whatever. But my energy was so low that that's what was coming out. And she, like...
fucked with it.
Yeah. And we got tight. And then, I found this new color to my acting that I didn't have before. You know what I'm saying? Because there was no reason or cause for me to have it. And so I always will attribute Weez to that.
All right, we got to stop the interview to tell you about the good folks at MyBookie, man. Now, look, NBA playoffs are approaching. Whew. March Madness is in full effect. What are we talking about? Get in on the action at MyBookie.ag. That's right. All right, if you want to bet on who you think is going to win the national championship in basketball, college basketball, on the women's side, on the men's side, man, so many specials going on. Go to MyBookie.ag right now. Sign up for a new account, and they're going to get you hooked up with that first deposit bonus when you use the promo code bootleg. That's right. MyBookie.ag. Use the promo code bootleg. Sign up for a new account. And you're going to get a first deposit bonus up to $1,000. What are we talking about? Playoff basketball. March Madness. People are playing hockey. I don't know why. Terrible sport to watch. Baseball season is approaching. Let's get it, boys. Let's throw some action in. Let's get in on that action. Let's get a little taste in there. Plus the full service casino. Man, blackjack. Craps, roulette, whatever the f*** you want to play, they got it at MyBookie. Promo code bootleg. Sign up for a new account. Thank me later when you're getting all that money. You know what I'm talking about? Also, want to give a shout out to our good folks at Odd Socks. You know, Odd Socks has a bunch of socks. I don't have any with me right now. But, you know, Cyrus is over here jerking his over here with his blue chew that he just popped. He just snorted a blue chew like a psychopath. But shout out to Odd Socks, man. Look, this was dope, man. WrestleMania is coming up. I got all my wrestling socks from Odd Socks. They got the WWE license, oddsocksofficial.com. That's right. Go to oddsocksofficial.com. They are the most comfortable socks in the world. I just have underwear here. Yo, wait, we got drawers. No socks. We got 38 drawers full of socks and Cyrus can't pull. Anyway, listen, if you've been watching the Bootleg Kev podcast in your life, bro, you just spilled my energy drink. You
didn't know your energy trick was there.
You got a serious cleanup job here, Cyrus. Anyway, while I'm getting bombarded with socks, if you've been watching the Bootleg Kev podcast, we love Odd Socks. They're our family. And when I tell you I only wear Odd Socks, like I'm about to take the sock off of my foot right now. Ugh. This is an Odd Socks basic. You see that? I'm barefoot right now. The most comfortable sock in the world. I invite everybody, just throwing shit. Like a psychopath, bro. I invite everybody to go to oddsocksofficial.com and participate in a level of comfort you did not know existed before. All right? So go to oddsocksofficial.com. Use the promo code bootleg. Save 20% at checkout. I suggest you get you some wrestling socks. Get you some Transformer socks. Maybe some half-baked socks. Yeah, let's get back to the interview. You said that they were going to bring it back?
Yeah, they you know.
Because they brought Dexter back.
Right.
And so it just didn't end up happening?
Nah, I don't know why it went away, but, you know, that was the scuttlebutt that they were talking about bringing it back. And I was like, damn, how did they bring me back?
You're dead.
Like, I'm dead. Like, maybe I just show up in, like, dreams to, like, help her through. I mean, she still got me tattooed on her ass. You know, it's funny that white women would send me tattoos, a U-turn on it. That's how insane
what
it was. I was like,
that shit's wild.
Y'all crazy.
The strange white women.
And my DM's like, look what I got. I'm like, oh, shit, this is crazy.
Another show you did. I never was a Blue Mountain State watcher, but I'm obviously very aware of the show.
Hey, I bet you a lot of your people is watching. Dave were avid.
No,
watchers.
I know it's a huge show. I know he loves the show.
Hell yeah. Radon Randall. You know what it is.
But I never got into it. But you played the running back, right?
No, that was the other black dude. This here. I played the quarterback, Radon Randall, who came after the running back. So they had to run him back in season one, and then he had to go away. So then they replaced him with a quarterback.
I heard it might get brought back.
I have been hearing that. That I think they're working on trying to make that happen.
Netflix or... Because I feel like shows get canceled, and then someone will buy it. Like, what was the Lucifer show, right?
Oh, yeah, and it was on Fox, and then it went away. Hulu or some shit.
No, it went to Netflix.
And then they made new seasons. They made new seasons, yep.
So I'm like, but I've heard that like, because when was the last season of that?
Lucifer?
No, Blue Monster.
Oh, Blue Monster. I don't know. Long, long time ago.
What was that on Spike? FX?
Spike.
Spike.
That's... Yeah, we only had three seasons.
Spike TV was the era.
Where the f*** is Spike TV at?
I don't think it exists anymore. Yeah.
Can you imagine having a whole network and your shit just becomes defunct?
Well, also imagine in 2024 being like, we got a network and it's only for men.
Ooh.
They'd be like, cancel it. They had like awards too, right? The Spike Awards? Yep. No, I thought Spike was fly.
Yeah.
I wish somebody bring back the Man Show.
The Man Show. That's Jimmy Kimmel, right?
And Corolla, yeah. But man, that show could never exist these days. It literally ended with the chicks in bikinis jumping on the trampoline, which was amazing. The credits would roll, and it would just be naked women on trampolines jumping up and down, and their tits would be...
Yeah, it's too many misses.
That's art.
To ever have a show like that.
Would you say that you're more passionate about being an MC or passionate about acting?
That's a good question, man.
Because you're in here with a wig on right now.
Oh, so the reason I have that on is because, like, I'm an avid Shakespearean advocate. Like, that's what I went to school for. It's my favorite playwright. And so I'm working on this thing to get Shakespeare over to the culture and to younger people so that they actually care about it. And
good luck.
Blending, well, hear me out and see what you think.
Bro, I was in school like, yeah, what's this?
And that's why I'm trying to fix it. So I'm blending hip hop culture with Shakespeare, and I'm creating this thing called Shakespeare for You, right? And so the first season that we hope to have is called Macbeth and Compton. And so imagine Macbeth, which I'm sure you don't even know what that is.
I know it's one of his famous plays. Right. I couldn't outside of Rome.
Denzel played him like just recently and got nominated for an Oscar. So
what movie?
Macbeth.
He was in a movie called Macbeth?
Yes, and the character's name is Macbeth.
I think the last one I watched he was in that got nominated was Fences.
Oh, yeah, he was dope in that. Mm-hmm. But so it's so imagine Macbeth meets Snowfall. Like, you know what I'm saying? And so what happens is...
Minus the tiger in the basement.
Minus the... Jesus, please.
Fucking, don't. They lost me. As soon as that scene happened, yeah, that I said, they're crazy. Done. I said, they just said, fuck it.
No, Snowfall is the shit.
Oh, it's great and wonderful. Up until that scene, tiger, I said, nope.
Yeah,
they lost me.
That was a bit wild. But no, so we're going to conjugate those two together. And just so that people that can understand, the subtitles won't be like what we're saying. It will be like the regular words for you to understand what it actually is.
So it won't
is
be like, going. So you're going to still do the...
I'm still going to do the words. They're still going to be the exact Shakespearean words. But now...
Subtitled
like so that you
understand. It'll be like City of God.
Yeah, so instead of now is the winter of our discontent, it will say now is the end of our bad times. You see what I'm saying?
Did you like Romeo and Juliet with Leo?
Yeah, that's
a great movie.
I wanted to do it because it made you understood it, right?
That was a fire movie, though.
Yeah, you got it though, right?
Yeah,
but regular Romeo and Juliet, you wouldn't, huh?
No. The regular Romeo.
Yeah, you wouldn't fuck with that, but you fuck with Leo, right? So that's what we're doing. We're putting it into a zeitgeist that you get and you understand, which is the mid '90s and the hip hop era, like the Death Row type of era. So imagine Tupac and Snoop Dogg like as these characters that are in Macbeth. It's gonna be crazy, you know. And I want to bring that to the world. And every season we'll do a different play.
Version
so it's like 22 minute episodes that go out like per season. And
what is the most popular Shakespeare? Is it Romeo and Juliet probably,
or Hamlet?
Oh, Hamlet. True.
Maybe. Yeah. You know, neither one of those are my favorites. Like,
what's your favorite?
Richard III. Never even heard of it. But listen, when I tell you. Oh, so back to this. So this is what Macbeth looks like MC8 in Menace to Society. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to MC8.
During that time pace. That's my favorite. My favorite time is the 90s in LA.
Like hip hop or just time?
Yeah. Like movies, hip hop. That is like, cause I'm in Detroit watching that and seeing Ice Cube, NWA, like Boys in the Hood, like all of that time period is so fascinating to me.
And very like, you know, it's kind of like a snapshot of like a time that, you know, for whatever reason, I don't know if we'll ever get that back, you know, like,
nah, you can't,
you know, like obviously LA culture is still heavily influential and people still wear Chucks and they still wear,
look, you got a socks hat on and they used to wear the socks hat
for sure. But it's like, it's just like that time, it was like, it was so new to the rest of the world that like, oh, these guys got creased Dickies and
the cars.
It was just new. And now with the internet, everybody kind of has an idea about what everybody else is doing, so it's not as like
the allure is,
yo, this whole mysterious just dropping of this new culture nobody knows about outside of California just dropped in the world's lap and you're like, oh, low riders,
yeah,
hydraulics.
Yeah, we didn't know about none of that.
That's
shit.
What I'm saying. It's
the
like
hair,
right? Jerry curls.
Yeah, we didn't know about like any of that. And so, okay, you're not a person who likes Shakespeare, but based off of what I just told you, is that something that you would be interested in at least seeing how that's done?
I check it out.
Yeah. See, yeah. And I hope that a lot of other like young.
So
people,
are you trying to get it funded, or are you trying to find a production company to do it with?
So
or?
I'm doing it with Terry Crews's production company.
Nice.
We are in this together.
Shout
and
out to Terry, man. Legend. Yeah.
Yes, yes, indeed.
That's, bought a lot of deodorant because of him.
Old Spice. But, you know, Terry and I, we went to the same college. We played for the same college, Western Michigan University.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, he obviously was before me.
Right. Terry's
but,
a legend, man.
Yeah, Terry's a legend. And so, yeah, we trying to make this happen. Like, hopefully.
They're going to start typecasting Terry Crews, man. I feel like he's always just like the real, like, lovable, like, goofy giant. You know what I'm saying?
Or the other thing, or the scary one.
Or the scary one.
I mean, he's going to be in this, and this is going to be interesting to see Terry, you know, well, hopefully.
Yeah. Nah, that's dope. Shout out to Terry Crews.
Yeah, man. So that's why. Yeah, yeah.
That makes sense. So would you say if you could pick one or the other, acting or hip-hop, what would it be?
Oh, so that's what I was explaining. It's very difficult for me because hip-hop is my first love. And even now, when people, like, give me laudations, I prefer it to come from the music. Because now when I hear somebody tell me, oh, they love me in this movie, or they love me
you're
in
used
the
to that
too. Like, I'm used to that, and I didn't write that shit. Like, me, my music,
right. You
I
wrote
created
it.
That
right,
shit
right,
from
right.
the inception of it all the way through.
For sure. It's different.
It's about my life. It's my
different.
Passion.
It's different.
And I got something to say that's important, and you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, The Meg is like a movie,
right.
But it's like, you just played a role that someone else
right.
wrote.
Exactly. So, yeah.
There's not a lot of substance there. It's about a giant shark. It's like, yeah, thank you. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, I mean, look, I love it. don't get me wrong. And I can act for the rest of my life. I don't know if I can rap for the rest of my life.
Right.
So that's why that's such a tough question for me, because, like, I'm going to act forever. I don't know if I'm going to be able to rap forever. You know what I mean? But my true passion is the music, because that's my therapy. That's my everything. Like, the type of music that I make, like, I'm like the most diverse actor / rapper in the world, because I'm not just like in one box. I do comedy as well as I do drama. I do Shakespeare. Like, my music.
You do stand up?
Nah, no. That's, I'm too for that. But I,
you
everybody trying to tell me,
you gotta,
yeah,
have some,
gotta,
balls to go on that
that's
stage.
That's the scariest shit in the world. I'm too pusillanimous. Because
you're gonna. Everybody goes up there and bombs.
They got
to
bomb.
You have to bomb your way through it.
I'm too sensitive. I'm too sensitive for that. So I can't do stand-up. But as far as the music, I do straight bars, like battle rap, like socially conscious music, bops, vibes, like it storytelling, which is obviously my biggest thing.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's just the amalgamation of things that I have to offer in both places are at the same level. Usually if you got an actor / rapper, they do one better than the other. But me, like, you know what I'm saying? I do both equally as good.
I'm just through my head. I'm thinking.
Ruminating right now.
Ice Cube. Ice Cube's pretty good at both, but Ice Cube's like all time great rapper. I don't think he's an all time great actor, but he's made some all time great movies. Friday.
Right. And then you also got to think.
T.I.'s way better.
You got to think about T.I.'s currently.
A way better rapper.
Who's doing it now? Both. Who's doing both things right now? Prevailing. You know, There's T.I., there's Donald Common. Glover.
Oh, Donald Glover. Listen, you got to give it to Donald.
Really? Donald Glover? Mm.
Listen, I think if you go back and you listen to, like, because the internet, and I think Donald Glover is a very high level artist, creative.
Yep, I actor. Agree. I agree.
Because even his last album, bro, that's one of my favorite albums to do shrooms to. That's such a great album to trip ball. Like, dude, yeah.
I think he's an incredible creative. You know, when I watch his acting and I think he definitely does his job.
Did you like Vince Staples' show?
Yeah.
I thought it was really good.
Yeah.
And it was short, it was quick, and it was random as but it was like very...
It was so random, it was good, it was different.
Like the last episode at the theme park was just trippy as I with it.
Mm-hmm. I auditioned for that show, I think. I auditioned for one of the cops in the first episode. And then they didn't even have a cop be black. The cops were white.
Yeah, they were white.
And they weren't even like... Like, what I did is not even like what...
they ended up doing.
Right.
Yeah. No, that was a good show. Vince's... But he wasn't acting. He literally played himself.
Right.
So it's different. But, I mean, it's not different. You got to also kind of be like... You could play yourself, but you also got to kind of know how to get lines off and, like, make it believable and not be awkward on camera.
Exactly. Oh, you know what? You know somebody I want to mention that I personally really... with actor slash rapper wise that's like doing both now is Joey Badass.
For sure.
I think Joey Badass is a dope MC such a dope actor. Like, and he has range.
Facts.
See, I care about like range.
Because he was on, he did the Wu-Tang Is he on one of the Power spinoffs?
Yeah, he's on the Raising Kanan. And he killed, listen, he's so good, I study him.
I will be honest with you. I'm such a...
You're what?
Fan of The Wire. That when I tried to get into Power, this shit was just a little too, like, it was just a little too unbelievable for me. I got like 3 episodes in and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna sit it out.
And you exited from all of the Power universes?
I haven't watched one of my best friends in the world is Freddie Gibbs. He was in one of those spinoffs and I never...
Oh yeah, Freddie Gibbs was in...
He's got the crazy Force. Eye. Yeah.
He was in Power Force.
I'd never watched.
I thought he did a good job.
No, he's a good actor. He was in another show that was on Peacock that he played a casino manager. It was a comedy that was like 2 years ago. He did great. He's a good actor. He just had a movie on Netflix, Down with the King, which is really good. But yeah, I think like, you know, I feel like acting and rapping is, you know, there's got to be some... Even if it's like 5% common ground, like you got to be vulnerable in front of strangers, right? To me, that's the hardest part. It's like when I think about acting or even stand up, like we were talking about, it's like the ability to not be awkward in front of people while doing art. Like,
well, you know, the crazy thing about that is I think that I could be awkward in front of like a lot of people, like, which is one of the reasons, like, I don't think I do well in like just random public speaking. Like, if you put me in a room, I can be like fun, silly way. But like, if you put me on the stage and I just got to talk to people, like, that's not something that's written, I would be mad uncomfortable with that. But like, as an actor, you know, you got mad takes. Like, if I mess up, then I could do it again. You know, I mean, it's kind of tough to do as a rapper, but
like, even like jumping takes, like, you got around you, the director, you got your co-stars.
Oh, they in their brain like this.
And then in my head, I'm thinking like, I'm annoying the co-star because they got their lines right.
They got their shit. I barely got some lines. This motherfucker got a whole monologue.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, I
can't. You can't do it. You don't act.
I'm good.
Would you do skits? Would you like?
Yes. So that is something I thought about doing. Not skits, but I with the like Shane Gillis and his partner. They do these like SNL style skits on YouTube, and I was just thinking, like, me and my co-host James Andre Jefferson Jr. on the radio show.
He's shout out to James,
yeah,
funny,
super funny guy.
Instagram,
but we were thinking, like, yo, we should start kind of like writing like real small, like 3 to 5 minute skits, getting Pure Spaces and just filming them, but having them be like super fucked, like just like some dark comedy, just see what happens, just for fun.
I think y'all should, because listen, like I said, like James is. That dude.
We got great ideas, but a lot of the ideas that we have are like, you know, they're pretty sick.
Ah, you can't even say it.
No, not it. Just like playing
with... So there was a squirrel, right?
And nah, like just playing with a lot of the like... It's like super sensitive right now. Like, and just like making fun of it, you know?
Right.
Like, yeah, we got some ideas. Hey, we got to stop the interview to tell you about our good folks at Blue Chew, baby. Everybody always asking me, does Blue Chew work? Yes, it'll have your dick hard. As super hard. Anyway, so look, if you want to find out if Blue Chew works, trust me when I tell you it's amazing. If you're dealing with erectile dysfunction, if you're dealing with maybe some stress at work and you're not performing in bed with your lady, whatever it is, man, all you got to do is go to BlueChew.com right now. Use the promo code BOOTLEG, and they're going to send you a month's supply for free. So don't take my word for it. They're just going to send you a month's supply for free when you use the promo code BOOTLEG at BlueChew.com. Now, BlueChew, if y'all don't know, it's the same active ingredient as Viagra and Cialis, but it's in a chewable form, and it gets delivered right to your doorstep in discreet packaging. The best thing about BlueChew is this, right? Blue Chew, you don't have to worry about going to no doctor's appointments. You don't got to worry about none of that. It's all online. It's all virtual. It's all online. It's all handled at BlueChew.com. So use that promo code BOOTLEG right now. Get a month for free. And your dick will be as hard as ever. Yes. And nobody enjoys a hard dick like Cyrus, my producer right here. Speaking of that, hey, can we give a shout out to King Palm? Oh my God, look at all this King Palm we have here. Jesus. This is why I love King Palm. Whatever you're into, they got for you. First of all, King Palm, 100% organic, all right? It's the world's best smokable leaf. Yes, flavors on flavors on flavors. Of course, here we've got our banana cream. What's dope about these is they're filled with the terpene, no tobacco, no nicotine. You squeeze the tip, you get hit with some of that banana cream flavor. They also got the natural joints right here. How about this? If you're into the more harsh tobacco leaf smoking, there we go. They got the tobacco leaf cones, banana cream, strawberry kiwi, just the natural sweet. Whatever you're into, what I'm trying to tell you is King Palm's got it at the highest level, at the most natural level, at the best smokeability level. And right now, you can save 50% off. It's 50, right? Yeah, it's half off. You go to King Palm right now, kingpalm.com, use the promo code BOOTLEG, you'll get half off. Or you could just go to your local smoke shop, your local 7-Eleven, and get you some King Palms. Let's get back to the interview. Sorry, guys, we had an audio malfunction. Let's just jump ahead. We're talking about his mixtape.
Oh, yeah.
Logic's on it.
Logic. Shout out to Logic. Logic got a dope movie that he wrote that
He's a movie fanatic. He's always had all of... Obviously, he's a big Tarantino guy, and I feel like... All his albums have some sort of theme to them. Yeah. So
and he's smart and he's funny and
he's written a book.
Mm-hmm.
So, was it Supermarket?
Yep.
Yeah. So he showed you a movie. It's like, did you see a movie?
No, I read it.
Oh, you read it. So you read the script.
Yeah, I read the script.
How was it?
And I don't even like reading scripts, honestly. I know that sounds crazy, like for an actor to not like reading scripts and someone with like a stellar vocabulary as myself not like reading, but I don't. But I read his script. Well, I kind of read the script. I use this thing where Snoop Dogg read it to me.
How do you do
there's this app that you can get where it'll read to you in other people's voices. So Snoop Dogg is one of the voices can choose. I gotta look at it on
my
phone.
That's fire.
But it's so far. I hit Snoop Dogg. I was like, hey Snoop, you know I'm reading Logic script in your voice. It's
so
like,
funny.
Yo, cuz, let me tell you something real quick. Like it was dope, but the script is fire. And so Logic is on my project. So I have 10 projects. Yeah. I have 5, you know, like regular albums, and then I got like 5 mixtapes, straight bars mixtapes. And at the end, the last song on each mixtape has a posse track with only incredible MCs. Right. And, you know, I got Crooked Eye, Elzai, Mickey Fax, Royce da 5'9", 3D Not T, Cassidy, King Los. And on this most recent one, it's Chris Rivers, Mickey Fax, Ciroc, who's super dope, and Logic is on that one. So, you know, I just want to showcase spitters because I don't want, like, listen, we got the fun music. We got the lit music, the shit that, like, my son's like, that's all important.
The Drake stuff.
Yeah, But we also need to hear somebody that actually took their time to write a bar as opposed to just freestyling.
Or an Instagram caption.
Exactly.
When someone disses you directly and you write two Instagram captions in a week instead of replying.
I think he's referring to some light-skinned guy who...
It's the most disappointing shit ever. It's been seven fucking days and we got two IG captions and a rant on stage.
Because he thinks, he's like, bro, I'm busy like on tour.
Oh,
like,
he gave Drake that, or he gave Meek Mill that action though, like
he did
right away. Just damn.
He had time today.
Back to back too. Literally back to back.
I know, that's funny. Hey, he took too long for that. I remember when that beef was going on, I actually made Charged Up. Remember he put Charged Up out first. And then it went away. And I redid Charged Up in Drake's voice.
Because Charged Up was very, very...
It was like kind of boring.
But then Back to Back was
and
like,
then Back to Back. So then I did that too.
And then I was like, yo, Meek's done. I really thought Meek was over with. I mean, and he kind of might be, but you know, he's a good guy, nice guy. He's Meek Mill. He's a legend, you know. But I think it helped when him and Drake... Because Dream Chasers 4 came out and it was really good.
Yeah.
But people acted like it wasn't really good. And I was like, yo, this Dream Chasers 4 shit is hard. But everybody still had that beef stench. And then they squashed their beef and I feel like it kind of helped everything.
Don't he have something now or something?
Yeah, he just dropped the EP
a couple weeks
ago.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out to Meek.
Shout out to Meek.
But I would like to see Drake.
Drake, you gonna respond?
Or
I think Cole. I think people really want to hear from Cole more than Drake.
I at least can appreciate that Cole hasn't put up passive aggressive Instagram captions instead of replying.
Yeah,
because Cole, I think is gonna. I don't think Drake's gonna reply. I think he'll reply in like 6 months on a guest verse.
It's gonna be subtle.
It's gonna be super subtle. I think Cole's gonna reply.
I don't think Cole's gonna. I think Cole
wants that smoke.
Does he? Cole should want the smoke because he's been rapping better than everybody else.
That's what
he's been
saying.
Going on everybody's shit.
I think Cole's
talking
one of them
his
ones.
Shit,
Cole's
beating
one of
his chest.
I think he's gonna reply.
He needs to show why he didn't. Kendrick say that he was like, let's see if he really wants these problems because Cole been.
The thing about Cole and Kendrick is they're so. You know they were. They recorded,
they were cool as hell.
And they were supposed to do a joint album together. And I look at both of them in the same light in terms of like, they don't do goofy shit. They're both top tier artists. They don't do any like cloudy weirdo shit. So I was just like a little intrigued by Kendrick. I think Kendrick took First Person Shooter as like a direct shot towards him. So I think.
So that's why he did that?
I mean, it has to be. Listen, I hope Cole replies. If we could get some sort of random, like, Cole Kendrick, I don't think Drake's replying. But if it was like a Cole Kendrick, like, Cold War for like a year, it would be fire.
You really think Cole is going to, because what is he going to do?
I think
come
Cole's
out
a,
blasting,
Cole's
like a whole
yes.
song,
Cole's
just strike directly?
I think Cole's a killer, for sure. I think he will. I think he's working on it right now.
I think he can.
I sure hope he does.
I think he has the ability. I just don't know if.
I think Drake's shaking in his boots. I don't think Drake wants to smoke, because I think Drake knows when he's outmatched, which is why he didn't reply to Pusha T. I think he knows when he's outmatched. I think he's really good at the cute little like light jabs.
They
or...
said they stopped him from replying to Pusha T. They said Jay.
Of course, that's what they say.
They said that
yes.
This was going to be go too far. Isn't that what Jay Prince said? That's that he what, had to yeah, dead it?
That's a very cute excuse. Because who's going to say, Jay Prince, it's a cute excuse. Pusha T came at you so crazy.
Damn.
Fucked up your sneaker rollout.
Damn.
Exposed your son.
Damn.
Talked about your man 40.
Damn.
And didn't get nothing back.
Oh, Drake, he's fomenting you.
Shout out to Drake. I think Drake's an all-time great. I love his music.
So do I.
But I want him to like, he wants to be like, dog, if you're supposed to be the greatest of all time, like some people say, I don't say that, but some people say it. Bro, now's your time. Have your Jay-Z Nas moment.
But it's against Kendrick.
And I'm sure people said to Hove, it's Nas. You don't want that. And you know what he did? He signed up.
I feel like Jay and Nas were more commensurate than Drake.
No, I think Drake is a
Kendrick.
I think Drake is a top tier lyricist.
So do I. but not like Kendrick is. Kendrick and Cole are.
To me, Kendrick is a God level rapper.
Right.
I feel like in the
last. I don't know if Drake is a God level rapper. I think he's a super dope rapper and he's clever and he keep that same pocket that he raps in. But.
Nah, Kendrick is different, man.
Yeah, Kendrick, you don't know where he coming from.
Kendrick's like with the White Walkers in Game of Thrones, bro. Like, you just don't know how to kill him.
Exactly.
Like, how do we kill this? This is crazy.
Exactly.
He turned a dragon into a fucking a White Walker. What are we supposed to do here?
Exactly.
And then, you know, Drake's like, who's a nice comparison to Game of Thrones that Drake is? He's like the kid who got poisoned. You know, the shitty
hell
little...
Hell no.
The young king.
He the one who jumps out the window. Remember?
Yeah.
The dude with the sister?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. That was interesting.
He pushed the dude off.
Speaking of shows that
no,
have...
No, we talking about the
shitty
the
endings.
You thought Game of Thrones had a shitty ending?
Terrible.
The whole season or just that one episode?
I hated the fact that they killed the White Walker so fast. It was like... that. To me, that war should have went on like a half a season. The whole show led up to that. And
I mean, it was one episode of just fighting. That was pretty intense.
Yeah, but they just... And then Khaleesi's turning heel turn was too quick. All of a sudden, this was just terrible. I'm like, we loved her all... Like, you gotta slowly build up to like her becoming like a villain. And they just... It was like a one episode heel turn. It was like such a slow, methodical show up until the end. And then they just hit fast forward on a bunch of... And then it was weak. Shout out to Game of Thrones.
Shout out to Game of Thrones.
Great show, though.
Oh, he said shout out to Game of Thrones, like the first ones until the finale came. Look, I enjoyed the finale because I'm a huge Game of Thrones fan. I watched it 4 times. So
it's a great show.
I'm biased.
Oh, it's a great show. I haven't watched
it. Wait, are you a Breaking Bad fan?
Of course.
Better Call Saul?
Of course. You know what's so crazy? Because my wife hasn't decided to actually sit down and watch Better Call Saul with me. I watched the first 4 episodes.
Come on, man, that's not enough.
I gotta watch it.
Better Call
I heard
Saul
it's as
is
good.
Just as good.
I've heard.
And Breaking Bad is the greatest show ever.
Not The Wire. It's not The Wire, but it's number 2.
You think The Wire is better than Breaking Bad?
Yeah.
How, Sway?
It's The Wire, then it's Breaking Bad. And it's those two, though. It's The Wire, then it's Breaking Bad.
To me, it's Breaking Bad and Game of Thrones 1A.
See, I would agree with you about Game of Thrones had it not ended terribly.
But what I'm telling you is Better Call Saul is right there because they have a character that was not in Breaking Bad, his wife. Her name is Rhea Seehorn. This is the baddest motherfucking actress on TV. Like, she is incredible. And she wasn't on Breaking Bad.
You got to hang out with the Jason Statham guy. How's he? Is he the...
The Jason Statham guy. Yeah, man. Jason's... That guy's amazing, bro. Like, he's awesome. He's an awesome person.
He kind of plays the same guy in every movie.
That's okay.
It's like him and Liam Neeson.
Yeah, exactly. I've been watching Liam Neeson. He's always, I'm going to get you. Like, no, Jason, though... Jason is incredible. I went to see The Beekeeper twice. That's how much ass he kicks in The Beekeeper.
Was it good?
Hell yeah, it was good.
I gotta buy it on Amazon.
Yeah, Jason Statham is the man. I f*** with him. Did you see The Meg 2? You didn't see The Meg 2, or you would have led with that.
I can't.
How dare you?
I didn't see The Meg 1.
If you saw The Meg 2, your energy towards me would be different.
I can't. There's just certain movies, and I'm like...
You don't like Jurassic Park?
No, actually.
Your wife doesn't make you watch Jurassic
Park? No, I've seen the first Jurassic Parks, and I watched the first new one. But then after that, I was like, I've seen enough. And then I heard how terrible the last one was. I like the ride, you know, Universal, it's solid, you know, but...
What the? Why you didn't tell this man about the Meg?
Busy man.
Yeah, when I saw
he watched everything. What you mean?
About a big-ass shark. Whatever. I get it. I know what happened.
You like Jason Statham, right? You never seen him fighting. You only see him fighting people.
Listen, I like Jason Statham. I like, but I'm not like.
Oh, you're not a sycophant of Jason Statham?
If he's in a movie, I'm not like, oh, we got to watch now.
Who's your favorite action hero then, if not him?
John Wick.
John, oh.
Yeah.
He can't run. But, hey, John Wick, bro. John Wick 4. Stop playing.
Before
bro.
Him?
I saw it 3 times in a movie theater. The stairs?
I like the mission. Oh, yeah, that shit's crazy. The stairs scene is insane.
Bruh.
I like the Mission Impossibles with Tom Cruise.
Yeah, Tom Cruise is a beast.
I enjoyed the Daniel Craig 007s.
Okay. But who stands out the who's on the summit of your action hero actors?
Ever for me personally? No, I think The Rock's overrated.
Damn.
I'm going to go Arnold. Sylvester.
Ooh, so he picked Commando over Rambo. So would I.
No, I said Arnold and Sylvester. I loved, like, True Lies was fire. Then I'll go, just because of John Wick, Keanu Reeves. Because to me, that's the best action series ever.
Yeah, listen, bro. He the Matrix, too? Like, you got to put him up there.
And then I'll probably go Asian. Jackie Chan.
Jackie Chan?
I loved like Rumble in the Bronx and all those like early Jackie Chan movies where the lips weren't matching the words were my shit when I was a kid. Damn. He's doing his own stunts.
Yeah, that's pretty dope.
You see him get all fucked up. Like he began hitting the stomach. You're like, oh, that was real.
Yeah,
fuck.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah.
That's pretty dope. And especially like me being in action movies and knowing like how like heroin, something like I almost drowned in the Meg 2. Like you don't imagine being in a movie that you
do. They even make like fake sharks for that, or is it all CGI?
No, it's just CGI.
Because back in the day,
they'll have a fucking
there'd be a fake shark. Yeah.
Look at this. The Meg is so goddamn big. Everywhere you look is the Meg. So
what? They killed the first Meg and they resurrected it for part two.
That's hilarious. No, the first Meg was killed, and
then there was like
a boat, and then another one came and ate that one. So it's multiple. It's a bunch. There's an aggregation of creatures in the bottom of this, under the thermocline. So it's not just the sharks.
So there's going to be part three then?
I hope so. Yeah. I mean, you survived? Make a lot of money.
Did you survive each one?
The black man. I'm the only one. It was me and
Jason
LL.
Jason Statham died?
Huh?
Did Jason Statham die?
No. I'm saying I'm the only black guy to survive
two
multiple
horror-ish movies.
Shark
movies. Yeah, because LL Cool J
died. LL, he survived, but they ain't have a part two. So I'm the only one.
What was that, Deep Blue Sea?
Yep.
Yeah.
They got Sam.
My hat is like a shark's fin.
They got, oh, I got a song in it too.
Good.
I got a song called Chomp that plays at the end credits of the Meg 2.
Go stream it.
Yeah, go stream it and watch the video. It's
well, listen,
like a shark fan.
We're going to have this guy do a freestyle.
Yeah.
Separate YouTube video.
Yeah, Detroit.
How do they find your music? Obviously, it's Spotify everywhere.
Yeah, it's everywhere. Everywhere. Paige Kennedy, everywhere. And unlike a lot of rappers, I got visuals to the majority of my raps. Like I said, I got 10 projects and I got like 60 music videos.
Damn.
Like high-end
ones.
High-end music videos.
Any movies or shows coming out?
I was in the Afion Crockett joint, a hip-hop story that just came out. I got a movie with Lil Rel and Rain Wilson coming out called Code 3. And, yeah, I got, like, one more joint that's coming.
Be on the lookout. Go support the music and watch the freestyle he's about to do.
Yeah.
Boom. Fire. Want to shout out to Hardeen, man. Hey, don't forget, this interview was brought to you by Hardeen, and when you're hitting Las Vegas, you got to stop off at Hardeen. Tell the Uber driver, the taxi driver, take me to Hardeen. They're going to take you. They're going to get you right. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you go visit them at HardeenLasVegas.com. Go follow them, Hardeen_LasVegas. And when you go and check out the most craziest premium selection of cannabis in the world, make sure you tell them I sent you. They're going to get you situated. Salute to Hardeen. Thank you for watching.